In this video, you will learn how to set a timer to execute a strategy at the end of every weekday. We will also learn how to code a simple moving average crossover strategy. So, let us begin by opening a new empty file, and name it with your strategy's name. Next, set a context flag that would help you check if the handle underscore data function has already run for the day. To do this, first import pandas with an alias as pd. Next, create a function called initialize with context as its input. Next, set the context.run underscore once as false, to show if the handle underscore data has been run in a day. Next, define a security to pull the data, by setting the context.security to a symbol. After this, we will create a function to handle the data, and generate trading signals. To do this, first, create a function called handle underscore data with context and data as its inputs. In the function, create a datetime object called sTime to capture the current day and time of the system. Next, we will write a conditional block of code that will check if today is a weekday. To do this, we will use the sTime object, and check if the weekday value returns an integer less than or equal to 4. This will cover all the days starting from Monday to Friday. After this, we will check if the current time is 2 minutes before market closing time. If it is, then we will check if the context.run underscore once is set to true. If both these conditions are met, then we will set it to false. Next, we will write a small condition block of code that will fetch the data of the security mentioned above just 1 minute before the close, and check if the crossover has taken place. To do this, we check if the current time is 1 minute before the close, and also check if the context.run underscore once is set to false. If both these conditions are met, then we will fetch the daily data of the past 20 days for the security mentioned earlier. We will accomplish this using the request underscore historical underscore data. Next, we will calculate the 5-day and 15-day moving average of the close prices. We will save the 5-day moving average in a variable called MV underscore 5, and the 15-day moving average in a variable called MV underscore 15. In the final block of code, we will write a conditional statement to check if the MV underscore 5 is greater than MV underscore 15. If it is, then it will indicate that the short-term moving average is more than the long-term average, so we will buy the stock accordingly. To buy the stock, we will use the order underscore target function with context.security and the lot size as its input, and assign this to a variable called order ID. Next, we will track this order using the order underscore status underscore monitor using the order ID parameter and target underscore status set to filled as its inputs. Had the crossover generated the opposite signal where the MV underscore 5 is less than MV underscore 15, then we would have set the lot size to 0 to clear the position. Please remember, in this example, we have not shorted the stock, instead, we merely closed our positions. This is a long-only strategy. Finally, we will set the context.run underscore once to true. Change the time zone to that of the users, and then compile the run underscore me file with the appropriate file name. Please check the output screen to verify the results. We will give you a short quiz to test your understanding of the topics we covered in this video. This is where we will end this course. Thank you for enrolling, and we hope you enjoyed learning throughout this course.